And you're looking now at Michelle Cameron and Carolyn Waldo. That's Waldo in the foreground, who's not been beaten in duet competition since 1985. Three times they've reigned as world champions, but they've never won an Olympic gold medal, and this is their final competitive swim, as it is for the Josephsons of the U.S., who've already completed a brilliant performance and currently lead the overall standings. The gold medal in this sport depends on what comes next in the 4 minutes that Waldo and Cameron will swim. Carolyn Waldo on the right won Olympic gold in the solo competition yesterday. Olympic Park Pool Hall, oversold. Over 10,000 are here to watch this final performance. And it's the final competitive performance of their careers for Waldo and Cameron. Carolyn Waldo, a signal figure in Canada in 1987. She was voted Canada's Woman Athlete of the Year, and she was selected to carry the Olympic torch at the Calgary Winter Games. Take the Josephsons. Waldo and Cameron will need a combined score of 98.36.
This is a very difficult move they're doing here. It's a blind spin. Generally well done. One of the things that Carolyn and Michelle do far better than anyone else is play to a crowd. They're going to show us here how they do that.
And we point out again, Candy, the seven judges do not have access to the underwater camera views that you see at the lower right-hand portion of your screen. ...90 seconds to go in their routine. Moment of truth as the Olympic gold medal will determine what happens the rest of the way. Synchronization, though, Candy, they say, has been a problem for the Canadians by their own admission in past competitions.
I think because the Canadians concentrate strongly on technical execution, they spend less time on synchronization. That does affect them in final competitions such as this.
Showmanship is a strength. They have the crowd clapping in unison as they begin the conclusion of their final swimming competition, going for the gold. The world champions, Carolyn Waldo and Michelle Cameron of Canada. Of practice a day for years going into that 4 minute routine. And now it's up to the judges. Karen and Sarah Josephson of the U.S. are the leaders at the moment.
Look at this move here. This is what separates them apart from the rest of the field in creativity. You can see here their legs are joined together. It's a blind move. They can't see each other. It's all experience.
The Josephsons scoring 99.60. Four tens were included in the seven judges' scores. High and low scores going out. These Canadian champions and world champions came in with a lead of just over a point, and they will need, from their final swim, point average of 98.36 to win the gold.
Look here at their arm action. Watch how Michelle pushes Carolyn out of the water at the end of the routine, not touching the bottom of the pool. Very difficult, shows a great deal of strength.
Carolyn Waldo on the right won Canada's first gold medal of the Olympic Games yesterday in the solo competition. It was a very emotional time for Carolyn and her teammates after the disqualification of sprinter Ben Johnson. 98.80. They win gold. The world champions reign as Olympic champions. Carolyn Waldo and Michelle Cameron of Canada overtake that brilliant performance by the twins from Bristol, Connecticut, Sarah and Karen Josephson. Needing 98.36, they score 98.80. And the Olympic gold medal goes to the Canadian team of Michelle Cameron and Carolyn Waldo. A second goal for Carolyn Waldo. We'll be back with the medal presentation shortly, as that is the final competitive swim in their careers. With Candy Casty-Burke, this is Don Cricky at Olympic Swimming.